I'm sharing my screen. Okay, let me know if it is visible or not. Is my screen is visible? Okay. Let's wait for 1 minute, 1 or 2 minutes. Let others come. 18 students. Siya, please text a message in the group that class will start soon. So last class we discussed method of joints, right? So this was the figure. This was the free body diagram of the truss member we discussed. And these are the support reactions AX and AY. And this was the support reaction DY. This was for roller support and this was for pin support, right? Till here we discussed. Till here it is clear. Till here it is clear. We have taken summation of fx equals to 0 and we got ax equals to 0. Then we take moment about d and we found out that ay equals to 500 newton. Then again we took summation of fy equals to 0 and we found out that dy is equals to 700 newton. Right? This part is clear, that how to find the support reactions. Response that this 500 and 700 is clear. Is this part is clear? How we get 500 and 700? By using equations of equilibrium. Is this part is clear? Please respond. Is this part is clear, or should I explain once again? Once again, ma'am. Okay. So see, this was our. I'm at the screen. I'm at the screen number. Let me. I am at the screen number 28. Is it visible? Please respond so that I can save my time of the meeting. Is screen number 20? Okay. So see, this was the truss is given to us. Okay, this was the joints A, B, C, D, E, G. Okay, these I have given these joints with some names. Then I've named these members as AB, AG, BG, BC and all this. Okay. These are the naming given to this truss members. And we have support, which is pin support, and one is roller support. So we have replaced these supports by reactions. Pin support is replaced. As you know, pin support has two reactions. So it is replaced by two reactions. That is AX, and one in horizontal direction and one in vertical direction. Okay, and this roller support has one reaction, so this will be replaced by only dy. So this is ax, ay, dy. So we have truss, we have our external reactions, which is ax and ay, dy, and we have external forces as well, 500, 500 and 200. So this is the final truss members with the distance. Member distance is given to you, 2 meter 2 meter. All the members is at distance of 2 meters. So what you have to do, your first step is always to find out this AX, AY and D. Your first step is to replace support by reactions. Okay, we have replaced those supports by these reactions AX, AY, DY. Now we have to find these reactions. Okay, so we have to use equilibrium equations. So we have let's use summing forces in the x direction equals to 0. So all the forces in x direction will be equals to 0. If you see this diagram, only ax is in horizontal direction, right? Rest forces are in vertical direction. So our ax equals to 0. Summation of all forces in x direction is equals to 0. In this figure, we have only ax equals to 0. So this will be the, I have taken this direction as negative. That is, this direction I have taken as negative. So that's why I have used minus ax equals to 0. Then you saw, you can also write as ax equals to 0. Right? This part is clear. So we have found out that ax equals to 0. Then we'll move to summing moments about d equals to 0. Okay? So that means we have to take all the moments about d points as 0. So how to find the moment? Moment is equal to force into displacement. How you find moment? Force into displacement. So assume this section, you have to find moment about d point. Assume this as a beam. Okay, this is your d y and this is your a y, and these three loads are acting. This 500, let me draw once again. Screen is visible and my cursor is I'm able to anode. You are able to see that. I've drawn a single blue line. Okay. So this is your AY, this is your DY. Okay. Vertical direction. This is your AY. This is your DY. And three loads are acting. 500, this one 500, and forget about the 200 because we know moment is nothing but force into displacement, right? So for 200 there is no distance, so this will become automatically 0. So we'll consider only these two forces, 500 and 500. Now see, this AY is a distance of 6 meters from the DY. This AY is at 6 meter distance from the DY. This 500 is at distance of 4 meter from the DY. 4 meter from DY. And again, this 500 is at a distance of 2 meter from the DY. Right. So, as you know, moment is equal to force into distance. So, I'm taking anti-clockwise movement as negative. This negative. So, force is your AY. Distance is your 6 meters. AY into 6 meters. Moment about this point. Then this 500 into 4 meters. Plus, I'm taking this direction as positive. Like this direction is positive. So 500 into 4 meters, force into displacement. Again, this 500 into 2 meters, this direction is positive, so positive. I've taken this direction as negative. So that's why minus 6. 6 meter into AY. So if you solve this, you will get AY equals to 500 Newton. As we got, okay, so you got AY equals to 500 Newton. So we have found out AX, AY. AX equals to 0 and AY equals to 500 Newton. So we are left with summation of all the forces in Y direction equals to 0. That means we have assumed the all the forces in horizontal direction as equals to 0. Summation of moments about a point at 0. Next, we left with summation of all the vertical forces equals to 0, right? So, see the figure carefully. So, we have vertical forces like AY, 500, 200 and DY, right? So, in this figure, I'm taking upward direction as positive and downward direction as negative. So, see, whatever be the direction of upward, I'll take as positive. See, AY. Minus, this is downward, so 500. This is downward, minus 500. This is downward, minus 200. And dy is in upper direction, so plus dy. And you know ay value from the earlier slide, that it's value of ay is nothing but 500 newtons. So I have placed this value, then I have found out that dy is nothing but our 700 newtons. So what we did, we replaced the support by these reactions, and we have found these reactions by using equations of equilibrium, right? So this is your final figure with your reactions.
AY 500, DY 700. AX equal to 0, that's why I have not shown in this figure. Till here clear? This response? These reactions are clear? You have to follow the same procedure of finding out the reactions in all kinds of process, okay? Okay. So see, the basic 3 points that your member will be either in compression, tension, or it may not have any force in the member. So you have to first assume that the member is in compression, either in fully compression or either in tension. So if you get positive answer, then you will understand that your assumption was right and the member was in compression. Suppose if you assumed a value compression, but you found out that at last you got negative value, so that means your assumption was wrong and that member is in tension. Okay. So let's start with, okay, one more point. You can assume any condition that you want for the members. I usually choose to assume that they are all in either tension or compression, and then let the signs of the solution dictate their actual condition. Okay. Since we can only use two of the equations of equilibrium, the sum of the forces in x direction and sum of the forces in y direction, our analysis pattern will be dictated by the makeup of the truss itself. Okay, I am at screen number 49. Hope it is visible. At any joint, you can only solve for two unknowns. So whatever joint you consider, you should see that you have only two unknowns. Suppose if you see in this figure, if I choose joint C, so see, I have four unknowns: BC, CG, CE, CD. So I cannot choose this one to solve this. Okay, at any joint, whatever be the joint, you can only solve for two unknowns. So see the joint A and D. At A, you have two unknowns, AB and AG. And at D, you have two unknowns, DE and CD. So you have to choose either A and D. After solving A, then you could move to, suppose I'm starting with point joint A. Okay, suppose I'm starting with joint A. So let's, after that, what joint I'll take? You have options of taking B or G, right? But see, at B you have, from A you will get to know AB, right? So at B now you have two unknowns, BG and BC itself. But if you see the G point, you have three unknowns. So which one you will choose? Definitely you will choose B joint. After choosing B joint, you will be able to know all these three members. This one and this one. Then after that, you can choose G member. Because you know these two values, you will be left with these two unknowns. Right? In the same way, you have to proceed. That you have to choose a joint in such a way that only two unknowns, you can solve for only two unknowns. This point is clear? Type yes in the chat box. This point is clear? How to start analysis? You have to start with a joint which has two unknowns, not more than that, because you won't be able to solve. Once again. See. Okay, let's start the numerical, then you'll understand. In our case, the pin at A and D both only have two unknowns, so we can start at either this. See, if you see the truss carefully, at D you have two unknowns, at A you have two unknowns, AB and AG. Right, AB and AG. And at D you have two unknowns, DE and CD. So you have to take a joint where you have only two unknowns. Okay. You cannot choose directly. You cannot start with joint B, because B has three unknowns. 1, 2, 3. G has four unknowns. 1, 2, 3, 4. E has three unknowns. 1, 2, 3. In the same way, you cannot choose any random point.
you always have to start with the joint which has two unknowns. So you can, in this figure, you can start with either A or you can start either with D. So I am choosing joint A. Okay, I have chosen joint A and I have drawn the free body diagram of the joint. So this is the free body diagram of the joint. This is 2 meter, this height is 2 meter, that means one, this angle will be 45 degree. As you know, 10, 45 is 1. So slope, this height and this distance, see this height is 2 meter, this base is 2 meter. So slope is 1 by 1. This slope will be 1 by 1. So slope 1 by 1 means your angle will be 45 degree. Okay. So you have to see AB is inclined in direction. You have to resolve AB into perfectly vertical and perfectly horizontal direction. Since this is the angle 45 degree, this is the theta. So this theta will, this will be also theta. Adjacent opposite angle, right? So I have already discussed the line where angle lies, that will always be your cos theta. So this your AB cos, here theta is 45 degree, so this will be 45 degree. So this vertical line will be AB sine 45 degree. This part is clear. This will be sine AB sine 45 degree and this will be AB cos 45 degree. Now you have to resolve all the vertical forces in all. Now you have to resolve all the vertical forces, all the horizontal forces. Okay. So I'm taking. Let's start with summation of all the vertical forces equals to zero. So here we have AB sine 45 degree. Here I have AB cos 45 degree. So vertical I have 500 and AB cos sine 45. Sine 45 is nothing but 1 by root 2. So I have taken upward direction as positive, downward direction as negative. So this 500 is positive minus AB sine 45 degree because it is in downward direction. So sine 45 is replaced by 1 by root 2, AB equals to 0. So from here, I have got that AB is nothing but 500 root 2 N. AB part is clear. We have found out the AB. Next, we left with AG. So for AG, AG is horizontal, right? So horizontal, we have AB cos 45 degree. So both are in the same direction, right? Both are in the same direction. Both are in the same direction. So I have taken this direction as negative. So minus AB, minus 1 by root 2 AB minus AG equals to 0. So we know AB value 500 root 2. So I have got negative value. So earlier we have assumed that the member was in compression. See, when you consider the member and compression, the direction of the arrow will be towards the joint. And if you consider tension, then the direction of the arrow will be away from the joint. So for the AB case, we got the positive value, right? So it is in compression and our assumption was correct, right? But for the AG, we got negative value. That means the member is in tension. So this arrow, basically this arrow will be in, this will be away from the joint. So for other member analysis, you have to take AG as tension member and AB as compression member. That is, arrow will be towards the joint and for the AG it will be away from the joint. So we have found out the AB and AG, right? So we have found AB and AG. So if I usually this will be adjoint, okay, for this truss it could be either pin B or G. We have found out for A, next we can move to either B or G. But at G we have BG, CG and EG are as unknowns. At G point, we have BG, CG and EG, three unknowns. So we cannot take G. But at B, we have two unknowns, BG and CG. So we'll start with joint B. Okay. So I've drawn the free body diagram of the B joint. I've taken the free body diagram of the B joint. So see, AB was in compression. We have seen that we got positive value for AB and it is compression member. So it is towards the joint. And I've assumed that BG and BC are also in compression. That's why I've drawn these lines in towards the joint. But after getting the values, I'll get to know that my assumption was correct or not. Right. But for the time being, I have assumed that these are in compression member. That's why I've drawn these arrows towards the joint. And this is the free body diagram of the joint B. Okay. Again, see, we have to resolve always inclined forces to perfectly horizontal and perfectly vertical direction. So we know this was the angle, right? So the same angle will lie here. So now this will be your AB cos 45 degree and this will be your AB sin 45 degree. So if you assume all the horizontal forces equals to 0, so this is your AB. I'm taking this direction as positive. So that's why AB cos 45 degree is positive minus BC is in this direction. That's why minus BC equals to 0. And we know AB equals to 500 root 2 n. I have put the value and I've got that BC equals to 500 newton and which is in compression. So our assumption for BC was correct that the member is in compression, right? Next, move to summation of all the forces in vertical direction. That is, this was AB sine 45 degrees. That means 1 by root 2 AB. So I've taken upward direction as positive, right? This is in upward direction. This is also, BG is also in upward direction. So 1 by root 2 AB plus BG minus 500 is in downward direction. That's why minus 500 equals to 0. Put the value of AB, then solve, we got BG equals to 0. That means our BG is a 0 force member. You might be asking yourself why BG is even included in the truss. This is very preliminary analysis of one loading condition. There is actually much more to truss design than this. Okay. Now we could go either joint C or G. At C, we have three unknowns. So we'll go to G where we have two unknowns, CG and EG. So our next point will be G. This is the free body diagram of the G. Now you can ask me why I haven't drawn the BG here. Because BG is a zero force member, so no need to draw this one. Okay, and from A point, we know that AG is in tension. So direction is away from the joint. And I have assumed that CG and EG are in compression. Okay, this value will decide whether these assumptions are correct or not. But from A joint, we have already found out that AG is in tension. That's why this is away from the direction. And this is towards the joint because these I have assumed as compression member. So same, this CG you have to resolve. Okay, you have to resolve CG as well. This will be the theta, so this will be theta. So this will be your CG. This will be your CG cos 45 degree. This will be your CG sin 45 degrees. Why 45 degrees? See, slope, this is 2 meter, this is 2 meter. That means your slope is 1 by 1. So 10 45 is nothing. 1 by 1, 10 inverse. If you find out the slope, that will be angle 45 degree. So this will be CG cos 45 degree. Direction will be like this. So resolve only CG is in. So if you resolve all the horizontal, all the vertical forces in all the vertical force equal to 0, so we have only one vertical forces, which is CG sin theta, and it is in downward direction. So minus 1 by root 2 CG equals to 0. Again, we have found out that CG is equal to 0. So this CG is nothing but zero force member. देन समेशन ऑफ एफ एक्स इक्वल्स टू जीरो, दिस इज अवर सी जी, सी जी 45 डिग्री. सो दिस इज इन, दिस इज इन दिस एंड दिस आर इन द सेम डायरेक्शन. सो आई हैव टेकन दिस डायरेक्शन एज नेगेटिव. सो माइनस ए जी दैट इज दिस पार्ट, माइनस ई जी दैट इज दिस पार्ट, एंड माइनस वाई हैव, देर विल बी वन मोर पार्ट. I have not considered. Okay. I have not considered CG 45 degree because I have found out that CG is nothing but zero force member. So CG is zero. So zero into 45 degree is nothing but zero. So we will left with AG and EG itself. So minus AG minus EG. We know the value of AG from the first joint A. I have put the value of minus 500 and I have found out that EG is nothing but minus 500. So our assumption of this one as compression member is wrong, and this member is in compression. The direction of EG will be this. So you can continue with the same pattern. Okay, you can continue with the same pattern. I'll give you this diagram and you solve for other members. I have found out for till G, right? You found for C, D and E. That means force in all others members. Okay. So I'll stop sharing my screen. That's all for today. Do one thing. Write your roll numbers in the chat box. All of you write your roll number in the chat box, please. Yes, I'll share the slide also. I'll share the slides also. I actually last class, due to network, I was not able to discuss this part. That's why I have discussed. Yes, I'll share the today's slide. You found out the other members, okay? In the next class, we'll start with this method of section. Hope everyone wrote their roll numbers. Okay, so next class, we'll start with one numerical, then we'll move to method of section, okay?